Drop it.
Welcome back. My passive income investors, like today, I'm going to be playing devil's advocate on all the reasons I think Nikola is just a terrible investment. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've never heard of this company, it is said to be the direct competitor to Tesla, focusing on hybrid battery vehicles, specifically in the tractor trailer niche. Now, keep in mind, they do offer some other vehicles, but I think those are just for branding for show, something like Tesla's doing with the Roadster or the first initial Tesla that was ever released, ladies and gentlemen. Now, everybody and their grandmother has been talking about this stock lately, and it led me to wanting to deep dive my fingers into it to see what all the hype was about. Now, you can't even directly buy into this company, but you can get exposure to it through this VTIQ acquisition company that is said to merge at some point with Nikola, giving them roughly a $3 billion valuation. And since people found out this company has direct exposure to Nikola, all of a sudden we can see this massive incline of like 160% from their lows. Now, I think this is an incredible kind of like pump and dump, maybe get in, get out. This is just my personal opinion, of course, but let's kind of dig our fingers into why I don't think this is the best company. Now, I went directly to their YouTube channel, and I suggest you watch through this because there is not a lot of impactful information. In fact, this company doesn't even have a full infrastructure built out yet. In fact, they only have one warehouse where they're building and testing prototypes with the hopes of basically partnering with a massive manufacturing company that's going to be doing the assembly line. So this company is still in its early stages. It kind of reminds me of what Tesla was a decade ago, and I'm going to leave the link to their YouTube in that description below, because once you guys watch through this, you'll see how they're still kind of in that infant stage. But let's kind of take a look at their products, their website, and continue to see what they're planning on doing. Now, I'm going to kind of break down the cost of hydrogen and some of the problems I see with it, but let's talk about the fueling aspect of it. The reason I like Tesla so much is you can plug it in and charge it at home. Unfortunately, with hydrogen, though yes, it is cheaper than gas, you still have to go somewhere to fill it up. And as we scroll down, we can actually see that it looks like they're going to be building a large infrastructure for fueling, something Tesla has done years ago, and this company has only planned this. It isn't actually like starting yet. They still have to get the plan built out and actually start building these things, let alone trying to figure out how to fill up hydrogen pumps, because that means tractor trailers are going to have to go all over the place to drop hydrogen off, whereas with a battery, you just plug it into any old wall. You don't need to actually go there and add a hydrogen to it. So just keep that in mind going forward as well. One of the biggest reasons there's so much hype around this company is primarily due to the fact of pre-orders. I think they have something like 1,700 pre-orders on their truck. So essentially they're saying you're going to get somewhere between 500 and 750 miles per fill-up. Now keep in mind going forward, guys, the average tractor trailer today does about 2,000 plus miles with a driver only stopping every 10 hours to take roughly a 1 hour break. I don't know how statistically proven that is, but the reality is essentially for every 2,000 miles, you're going to have to stop four times to fill up hydrogen, whereas you'd only have to fill up gas once. Now, that is something very important to take into consideration, as they say it takes about 15 minutes to fill up a hydrogen tank, and that comes into a bit of a problem, right? Because, I mean, if you're traveling 2,000 miles and you got to stop every 500 miles to fill up, killing 15 minutes, well, that's an extra hour of time wasted that you could have spent on the road and only filling up a tank of gas once. These are things you really have to take into consideration. Now, my biggest problem with these hydrogen hybrids overall is just the pure cost. Now, these vehicles are extremely comparable to Tesla, considering, again, hydrogen is much lighter, and if you can kind of morph it in with batteries, you're going to be getting a little bit more efficiency going on. But let's kind of break down the cost of hydrogen real quick, all right? To refill, the long answer, hydrogen fuel prices range from about $12.85 to more of about $16 per kilogram. And it also breaks it down into miles here to help you out, which translate in an operating cost of 21 cents per mile. So if we divide that out, guys, over the 750 mile range at the top they are expecting you to get, that's $157 per fill up. Now, if we were to compare it to something that was only battery, so let's get into here, guys, we can see that the average battery to fill up basically is 11 cents per kilowatt. And if we divide that down into miles, essentially we're going to roughly 4 cents a mile in cost. And if we divided that out as well, we can see actually it's only going to cost us $30 to travel the same distance if it were just battery over hydrogen, right? So, I mean, the costs are still a little bit higher overall than something like a straight battery vehicle. Now, some of the biggest problems that Nikola and Tesla face are essentially extending range, because right now the biggest problem with tractor trailers is trying to get up to the range where you're getting that 1,000 to 2,000 miles. And now the efficiency you lose with batteries is weight. Hydrogen is actually lighter than air, really bringing up the efficiency level. The only problem is hydrogen doesn't operate as efficiently as batteries do, because essentially if hydrogen gets too cold, it becomes useless. It kind of renders the fuel and you can't actually use it anymore. And same if it gets too hot. If it gets too hot, the fuel becomes useless. And not only does the fuel become useless, you have a really high chance of this stuff blowing up, because hydrogen is way more explosive than gasoline or diesel is overall. So essentially going forward, we're just trying to figure out the costs of where this company can kind of get them down to be actually a direct competitor with Tesla. Now, Tesla hasn't said anything about the tractor trailer they're bringing out. And if they can get the fuel efficiency of those batteries down and extend those miles by way higher, they're going to be miles ahead of these guys, because again, battery technology is just better than hydrogen, which is why this company is even trying to fuse the two of them together. But the biggest moat that Tesla has over this company, completely setting aside the infrastructure aspect of it, is self-driving. This company doesn't even consider self-driving to be a possibility yet. I'm sure they would adopt it into their systems, because I think whether you're talking about gasoline, whether you're talking about batteries or hydrogen, the real cost savings come into, can these vehicles drive themselves? If you can build a tractor trailer fleet where one guy operates in the front and all these other tractor trailers follow it, like Elon originally said might be the original rollout of the self-driving tractor trailer, I mean, the money that is going to save is so unbelievably large, especially if there's no fuel costs associated. So essentially where it stands today, ladies and gentlemen, this is just purely a hype stock. It is purely speculative, hoping that their little warehouse where they're tinkering around with their 3D printers and all their toys to try and bring up the efficiency and build a half-decent prototype. I mean, they are so far out, guys, from being anywhere near close profitable, whereas Tesla's already starting to prove profitability with the few sales they have. Like, the sales they're having compared to the potential with batteries, self-driving, you know, they have their solar roofs, like they have such a broad spectrum of products. I still think even at the valuation you're paying for Tesla, your rate of return, I think, has a higher potential than something like a Nikola does. Nikola is just one of these companies, I think, where people can try and jump in early. If the tech works out, they can have somewhat of a small niche, similar to like what BlackBerry was trying to compete against when iPhone came out. But unfortunately, in this case, you know, Tesla came out first, dominated the competition. Now everybody is essentially a BlackBerry or a Samsung in comparison. And I wouldn't even compare them as a Samsung yet if, you know, Tesla is comparable to an iPhone. Now, obviously in this video, I'm being a little bit harsh on this, but I'm just throwing in some factual information. You guys really need to do your homework. I really hate spec plays like this, because when most people start buying into them and the entire community starts kind of revolving around, oh my goodness, the stock is blowing up, it's going to be a competitor to Tesla, look at what they're doing. But when you get on the ground floor, you start realizing that this company has nowhere near the capability that Tesla has in this current position. In fact, something like a BMW has a higher capability of giving you a greater rate of return on electric vehicles than something like a Nikola does, in my personal opinion, as it stands right now. So when people get into these companies, I really wish they would just sit down, because chances are, I guarantee you, most people that currently hold this stock don't even know how hydrogen engines work, let alone how hydrogen has to get produced. Because again, guys, hydrogen is made from natural gas, from fossil fuels, by steam reforming of natural gas, partial oxidization, and methane. So I mean, just like batteries, at some level, there's still going to be cost of emission, because you got to go out, you got to mine the materials, you got to find a way to make that efficient as well before the whole entire environment becomes fully sufficient. And that is more likely to happen with batteries than it's ever going to happen with hydrogen. So please, guys, if you're looking into spec plays, like I talked about with MindMed, sit down, do your research, understand the full scope of what they're trying to do, and then see if the technology is even comparable. At some point, you got to do your homework to the level where you can fully understand the efficiency versus cost, and then you have to compare it to currently what exists. Is those headaches that this causes overweigh the headaches of something like a diesel tractor trailer, you know, having to stop every 500 miles four times as much compared to a regular tractor trailer? Does that add on cost lowering the efficiency of hydrogen? I don't know, guys. There's a lot of things that come into play here. I do think there's probably some incredible potential behind this company. I've just looked into this and I haven't done a whole lot of homework aside from what I've done from last night and today, and I could be missing a lot. And that's why I'm hoping playing devil's advocate is going to lead you to dig deeper down into this company and hopefully find something that is kind of a morsel grain of truth, of value, that makes you think you should be buying it. Because honestly, I think it's a bit of a joke and a bit of a pump and dump. Just my opinion. Love to know what you think in that comment section below. But stay cool, stay awesome, and I look forward to chatting to you tomorrow.